Hi guys, I'm Lillian, aka Stitchy Me on Instagram and here on YouTube. I'm coming to you from the Netherlands on the 25th of October 2020. And welcome back to my second YouTube video. Still a bit nervous, but I will nail this. Let's do it. So, okay. First of all, like some of you may have noticed at the end of my last video, it cut off. It did not really stop recording, it just made it into a second video. So it kept on recording, but there were two videos. One of the 33 minutes that you have seen, and then another like 10 minutes that got cut off. And I only noticed when I watched it back and I had already uploaded it. So yeah, but that's fine, because I will just, you didn't miss a lot. You only missed a sock and some plants, but plants will, I will talk about the plants some more in another video. And in this video, I will show the sock now. So, okay, I've done quite a bit more than the first time I showed this, but you didn't see it. So, this is my sock. So, like I was trying to tell you guys, this is goat's wool. It's a Dutch thing, I think. It's not really goat's wool, but it's just called goat's wool. I don't know why. But this is what we traditionally like wear in our wooden shoes. So my grandmother used to knit those for her sons, and but she's gone now, and my father has worn off all of them, all of the pairs he had. So I decided to try it and knit some. So, okay, last time I had done the leg and the heel flap and the heel turn, and I've now picked up all the gusset stitches and did a lot of the foot. I have like four more rows to go until the decreases for the toe. And I'm quite proud of myself, if I may say so. This is my very first sock. It's not like flawless. There's a lot of tension changes and stuff. Also because I tried to I tried the continental style stitching, knitting. So yeah, there's a lot of experimenting in this sock, but that's what it's for. Okay, that out of the way. I also noticed in my last video that I missed a lot of details, information on Waterhole Master. So I'll tell you now. This is the pattern. If my hands will stop shaking. And okay, so I ordered the fabric from Lakeside Needlecrafts. I am doing it on a 28 count easy grid from Zwijgaard. 2/1 10 stitch. And it will be my birthday new start. So that's the 10th of December. Breathe. Okay. So that's my Waterhole Master. I'm really excited for this. And I will be doing it extreme cross country, doing the black first. I stole that idea from Kim, Spartan Stitcher. So yeah, okay. That's all of the corrections from last video. So now we can get into this video. As you may have noticed in the title, there's no Q&A because nobody asked me questions. That's fine. We will get to that when you do ask questions, and you can leave questions or anything you would like to say anytime, anywhere, like on my Instagram or here in the comments. And I will answer them either commenting on your comment or in a video. So, let's see. But I will give you guys some live information about me, because that will help explain when I will be able to upload and how often I will be able to film. Okay. Let's see how I can make this clear. So I live, I'm currently in Apeldoorn, the Netherlands. This is my parents' home. So I was born in Apeldoorn, not this home, but in Apeldoorn. And I was raised here. And for my study, I'm currently studying animal management in Leeuwarden. So that's like 2 hours by train. And I have a little apartment there. So I am there throughout the weekdays and when I need to go to school. And I'm here in the weekends in Apeldoorn. And if I would, so okay, because I'm half of the time I'm here and half of the time I'm there, I've also splitted my projects. Half of them are here, half of them are there. So if I would decide to do a weekly update here, that would mean that I will have to carry some of my projects back there, back here, every single week. So that's kind of, I don't know if I want to do that. I might change my style of stitching, where I'm currently stitching on one project for like 3 days and then switching. I might like pick one for every week, and that way I would only have to carry one with me. Or the other option is doing a like vlog style update for you guys. But that, if I want to do that, I will have to learn how to edit and how to put pieces of material or footage together. And I don't know if I want to do that. Because I like the idea of just not adding the editing and just throwing it on YouTube. So I'm not quite sure if I will have a rhythm or if there will be a like a schedule when I will upload. I do want to make it more frequent than once a month, but it's going to be at least once a month. So don't worry that I will go inactive. I will stay active because I just like it too much. Then. So that's the explaining for when I will upload. Yeah, I guess we can go into Etsy. That was in the title, because it's in the title, I guess, when you see it. So Etsy. I already have an Etsy shop, which started out as an experiment. A friend of mine started her Etsy shop, and I have always been interested in like making my own handcrafts and then selling those, or trading in like the medieval style of gaining money. And that has always been fascinating to me, like not getting paid for by hour for a job behind like on a chair and behind the desk, but getting paid for the amount of work you put in and like the amount of products you produce. That's really fascinating to me. I don't know why, but it just is. So I started an Etsy shop just as an experiment. If it didn't work out, it's fine. If it does, fun. So yeah, but I wanted to do it right. So all of the like research I did on how to do an Etsy shop, how to run it, how to set it up, they all said to pick a niche. So I did. So I started with making friendship bracelets, and those are already on my Etsy currently, and I will link my Etsy down below. So that is what I have in there. So my first listing is this bracelet. It's a Starburst bracelet. This took me like like 10 hours to make, I think. Yeah, but it's cool. It's really cool. It has twisted ties with these thingies that I made up, and I think they're pretty. So that's one listing. I have one listing with three rainbow bracelets. Those three, they all have twisted ties, and most of them have a loop, but like this one has twisted ties on both ends. I have two sets. So this is a set, one bigger bracelet, and oh, this is the other way around, and one smaller with a charm on there. I think it's really pretty. And I have another one in different colors and a different kind of pattern. Again, wrong way. I have to practice this. And then I also have made something a bit different. So this is a anklet slash bracelet. This is the anklet version because it's longer, but you can wear it as a bracelet if you want it to be a long tail. It has a lobster clasp thingy, and you can just put it on wherever you want to. So these are gold and silver beads, and you just put it on like that. And then the only product that has been selling are these thin bracelets, and these are the only colors that I have left. Oh god, it's not focusing. Hello. Well, I guess you get the idea. Oh, there it is. It's macrame. It has a loop at the beginning and then two ties with a bead at the end. Okay, so they are selling, but the problem is that I cannot reproduce them because the supplier where I got the threads from changed their color scheme. So I cannot get the colors anymore. So I could change the colors and make new pictures and stuff, but I haven't had time to do that yet. So those are the current listings. And then I have a few more products that I dropped on, that I already have made but are not up on there. They don't have a listing yet because I haven't made good pictures yet. So first of all, I made this scrunchie, and please know this is hand sewn. I do not own a sewing machine, so this is all sewn by hand, and I'm pretty proud of it. There's a seam, it's all invisible. So yeah, that's just a scrunchie. And the pattern, the fabric has a, it's like roses on them. So that will be on my Etsy pretty soon. And then I also made these macrame gemstone necklaces. So I have three of them. So, hello, please focus. Is it focusing? It's not focusing. Kind of. Okay, so this is white rose quartz, this is pink rose quartz, and this is amethyst. And then I put them in a net and I macrameed, I braided the, what do you call this? Like the actual necklace itself. I don't know how you call it in English. And then I made a slip knot on the end so you can pull this. So you make it as wide as it can, and then you just put it on and slip knot tie it where to where you want it. And it will not come loose until you actually pull it loose yourself. So those will be on my Etsy soon too, once I actually have pictures of them. And then there's another product that I'm working on. So I remember those thin bracelets, since they are selling, I figured I would make a variation on those because people seem to like them. So I made these black and white bracelets. They are a tiny bit thinner because this is a different kind of thread with a loop at the end, ties at the other, and you can choose to either order these separately with just this, or, and I still have to make samples of those, buy them with a charm. So I ordered some charms and I have gotten those, but I haven't made any bracelets with them yet. But once I do, I can make pictures, put them up on Etsy. So there are, I have two different kinds of charms that are like in the middle, so I can tie them on both sides. And then I have like three or four different ones that hang like the crosses on the other one. So that's in progress. And then, okay, so that's what I started out with. With a niche. But now I got the idea, I kind of got sick of, oh yeah, I can only put products on there within my niche. And I'm not doing it to make money. I'm not doing it to be a serious business. I just want to have fun. And then combined with the idea of, I am currently not doing a lot of stuff that I want to be doing because I will not use them, the products, afterwards. Like, I would like to make a lot of stuff, but I won't use it. So that keeps me from making them because it costs a lot of money and time and effort to make them. So those two combined made me think, like, well, what if I put like anything I would like to make and it turns out good enough quality to sell, just put all of them on my Etsy and see if somebody else will like that. So then I will be able to make whatever I want to, and I might make other people happy with what I made for them, basically. Of course I can make people happy by just doing a giveaway, and I will do giveaways. But just giving away everything I made, there will be going a lot of time and money in there. So that's just not realistic. So that's my plan for the future on my Etsy. So that means that there will not be only bracelets and jewelry on there. That means that there will be knitted and crocheted stuff as well, like baby hats or crocheted scrunchies, or if I made socks or whatever will be on there. And also like cross-stitch stuff. Perhaps I will sell some of my finished works, my finished pieces, because I do not have room for all of my pieces in my little house. And some of the pieces I also just would like to stitch, but I wouldn't necessarily put them up in my own house, so then maybe I can make somebody else happy with them. But also, what I'm kind of most excited about, and I need your help for this, by the way, is because I would like to make my own cross-stitch patterns. And I already have this huge idea, and it's been in my head for like months, for a stitch-along. I will not spoil like the actual pattern idea, and of course this is for in the far future, because I still have to find out what program I will be using, and then I have to make the pattern and make sure I can sell it, and maybe do a test stitch, I don't know. So yeah, but I need you guys to tell me what programs you use for your patterns and which ones you would advise for me to use, as a beginner, and also preferably really cheap programs, because I don't have a lot of money, I'm a poor student. So yeah, that's really exciting. I would love to make my own patterns and share them with the world. And anything else? Yeah, I think that's it. Those are my plans for it. Pretty much. Okay, so, and again, if nothing sells, that's fine. I just want to try and see if I can make people happy with some stuff I made. Yeah, just an experiment. We'll see. I think that's it. So, okay, just as a reminder, feel free to ask me anything from Sitchi related to my private life to other topics, whatever. If I find it appropriate, I will answer. If I don't find it appropriate, then I won't answer. And don't think I'm mad at you. Just I might answer it like in a private conversation or something, but just not in the video. Just always ask. If you're doubting if you can ask it, just ask. I will always give a answer. If it's the answer you're looking for, don't know. This is getting way too complicated. Just ask your questions. My Instagram is Sitchime, same as here on YouTube. And then, oh yeah, and the next video will probably be an update. And I would like to do that, no promises though, in the next weekend, because that will also be the first of the next month. So that will go nicely together with my goal setting and stuff. I think that's it. So happy stitching. I totally stole that from Darren. I'm sorry, Darren, but I like that quote. happy stitching, and I'll see you next time.